When people think of threats and dangers in the backcountry, they usually think of like big scary things, right? They think of bears, they think of mountain lions, they think of your mom. And while all of those things can be dangerous and can be threats in certain situations, the thing that I want to talk about today is not some big scary animal. It's actually a very, very tiny little insect thing, and that would be ticks. Ticks. With all that said, this is going to be a sponsored video. That's right. Well, assuming they don't pull the plug after that your mom joke, but a huge thanks to Sawyer products for sponsoring this video. It's honestly a perfect partnership because I've been using Sawyer's products for 5 years now. I've been using their water filters forever, and I've also been using their permethrin spray for years and years and years now, including on my Appalachian Trail through hike. And that's a product I'm going to be talking about quite a bit today because it just so happens that using Sawyer's permethrin is one of the best ways to keep yourself safe from ticks and safe from Lyme disease. Before I started planning for this video, I obviously knew about Lyme disease. I knew that ticks were dangerous, which is why I was using Sawyer's permethrin in the first place, but I didn't really know that much about Lyme disease specifically. After talking with Sawyer about this video, they pointed me in the direction of a bunch of specific information about Lyme disease that really show exactly what it is and how dangerous it can be. Just for clarity's sake, let me read an official definition from the CDC's website. Lyme disease is the most common vector-borne disease in the United States. Lyme disease is caused by the bacterium Borrelia burgdorferi. It is transmitted to humans through the bite of infected black-legged ticks. That sounds pretty damn nasty. Lyme disease is mostly prevalent in the northeastern part of the United States. But contrary to popular belief, it has actually been found in all 50 states. Ticks can carry other diseases too, like Rocky Mountain spotted fever. Not to mention that getting bit by a Lone Star tick can actually make you allergic to red meat, I guess. Which, to be honest, I don't really know that much about that topic. This is going to be mostly focused on Lyme disease, but I just think it would really suck to not be able to eat cheeseburgers anymore. Over 300,000 cases of Lyme disease are reported to the CDC every single year, and the crazy thing about that is the CDC estimates that that number is actually lower than the actual number of Lyme disease cases because apparently they have reason to believe that people severely underreport this illness. I'm not trying to like scaremonger here, but I just really want you guys to take this seriously. I know a bunch of you out there already do, but it's so true. Ticks are tiny. You can barely even feel them crawling. I've felt them occasionally while they're like crawling up my really, really hairy legs, as we established a few videos ago, but for the most part, you're not gonna feel them crawling on you. You're not gonna feel them bite you either, which is the sketchiest part. And of course, they like to tunnel themselves into parts of your body that don't really stick out very much. So sketchy to say this, but places like behind your ears or your waistline or even like your armpits and stuff like that. I mean, it grosses me out just thinking about it. Again, I'm giving you this information so that you can take this threat seriously. And with that said, let's stop talking about the bad stuff and let's focus on the good stuff, how you can prevent Lyme disease and prevent all the other nasty illnesses that come with tick bites. In my opinion, there's two main things you can do to protect yourself from ticks. The first, as we've already established, is to treat your clothes and your gear with permethrin, which I'm gonna talk about in just a second. And the second thing is to check yourself regularly for ticks. And I'm gonna also talk about that towards the end of this video as well. But let's talk about permethrin. So like I said, I've been using Sawyer's permethrin for legitimately 5 years now. I used it on most of my hikes before the Appalachian Trail. I used it on the Appalachian Trail, and I've used it on all of my hikes since the Appalachian Trail. And here's the kicker, folks. I've never been bitten by a tick while wearing permethrin-treated clothing or using gear that was treated by permethrin. It's never happened before. I did get bit by a tick in high school one time, but it wasn't even like when I was hiking. It was like after prom, like I was at a party and I woke up the next day and I had a freaking tick in my stomach. I guess I should have treated my tuxedo with permethrin. Like, it's been proven that you are 70 times less likely to get bitten by a tick when wearing permethrin treated shoes and socks. F*** yeah! One of the things that I really like about this is you don't have to just apply it every single time you go out. You just spray your clothes and your gear with this one time, and then it lasts for either 6 weeks or for 6 washes, whichever comes first. So I just think that's really convenient because you don't have to be like spraying yourself down every single time you want to go for a hike. I know the thought of using chemicals for stuff like this kind of freaks people out, which is understandable. So just know that this stuff is not toxic. It's approved for use by the EPA. Another great thing too is that it's odorless after it dries. I don't know about you guys, but I usually smell like shit when I'm hiking. Well, I'm assuming you probably do too, but it'd be pretty embarrassing if I like rolled up to a campsite smelling like a sweaty, stinky piece of hiker trash, and then I also smelled like chemicals. Like I've said, it's not only good for your clothing, but you can also use this stuff on your gear, your tent, your pack, things like that as well. And it's even safe for your dumbass dog who keeps running off the trail, jumping around in a bunch of bushes and coming back to you completely covered in ticks. Fido would be f***ed if you got Lyme disease. Keep him safe, folks. I don't know if Sawyer's gonna let me keep this in. I will say that permethrin is not safe for cats when it's in its liquid form, but that's not really an issue because I don't know what kind of weirdo is hiking with a cat anyways. So I just threw a bunch of permethrin facts at you guys right there. You might be kind of convinced, but a little bit skeptical because you're like, Kyle, it's probably a huge pain in the ass to like treat my clothes with this stuff. And that's where you're wrong. Let's go do a demonstration on how to effectively treat your clothes with Sawyer's permethrin. Like, I don't even know if I'm gonna be able to fill enough time in this video with the demonstration because it's honestly super easy, but let's see how I do. All right, so I'm gonna show you guys how to treat your clothes with Sawyer's permethrin. It's really, really easy. One thing I want to say here is that this stuff doesn't just repel ticks, like it doesn't just keep them off of you, but it actually kills them. So if I was a tick, for instance, and like I'm going up and, oh, I'm gonna crawl up your leg and then, all right, so step one in the permethrin clothes treating process is to just hang your clothes up on a clothesline like this. Now, pretty sure clotheslines are illegal in my HOA, but please don't tell anybody. So for most normal people, you probably have some clothespins laying around your house. Now, I'm kind of a scumbag, so I don't. So I just used a little bit of duct tape. So the way you're gonna wanna actually treat your clothes with this stuff is you're gonna stay about 6 to 8 inches away from the garment. You're gonna use a slow sweeping motion and you're gonna spray each side for about 30 seconds. So I'm gonna start with my socks here. So as I said before, treating your socks and your shoes in particular is really, really important. Ready for this sweeping motion? It's kind of hard to sweep with a sock, I guess. Now we'll get the 46 Climbs t-shirt, which I hiked in the other day and have not washed, because again, I'm kind of a scumbag. Now, like I said earlier, you should definitely be treating your gear with this stuff as well, not just your clothing, because obviously your backpack could brush up against some brush or something and could get a tick. So we're gonna treat my backpack as well. And lastly, as I've said a few times now, footwear, you really wanna treat this stuff. You're gonna get a lot of ticks that are low to the ground that are gonna brush up against your feet and, you know, your ankles and stuff like that. So you definitely wanna treat your shoes. Just gonna go ahead and blast the shit out of these. Well, now we're gonna go do the backside. So clearly this is super easy, doesn't take much time or effort at all. Like I said before, you can also treat your dogs with this stuff. So my dog's not home right now, but let's go see if we can find one of the neighbor's dogs to treat with this permethrin.
Hey man, can I spray some stuff on your dog?
Excuse me? F*** off, man.
Now, as I've established here, treating your clothes with permethrin is super, super important in protecting yourself from ticks. However, there's one more thing that you can do on the trail that's gonna keep you safe. That would be checking yourself for ticks. Now, at surface level, that sounds pretty basic, right? Like you just check yourself, and that's the kind of advice that people give to hikers a lot. They say, just go check yourself for ticks at the end of the day or whatever. But I think it's a little bit more complicated than that. Maybe not complicated, but there's just a little bit more to it than that, I guess. There's basically two certain scenarios where you should make a complete habit out of checking yourself for ticks. The first one is at the end of the day when you're backpacking or hiking. I don't need to explain the technique of how to check yourself for ticks, but I guess just be careful and be mindful of those areas I mentioned earlier, the areas that are kind of tucked away, the ticks like to hide in, which is so gross. And then the second scenario that you should check yourself for ticks in is anytime you brush up against a tree or weeds or brush, when you brush up against the brush, that scenario. I mean, check yourself immediately after it happens. Don't walk through a field that's really overgrown and then be like, oh, I'll just check myself at the end of the day. No, as soon as you get out of that field, stop. Freaking take your pack off if you have to. Check your legs, check any part of your body that was touching or near the grass or the brush or whatever you touched. If you do this, I can almost guarantee you're gonna catch most of the ticks before they even get a chance to bite you, before they even get a chance to really crawl around your body at all. I would just highly recommend you, again, make it a habit, make it a part of your routine, especially, again, if you're up in the Northeast, on the Appalachian Trail, places like that. Check yourself after you go through any sort of field, after you touch any sort of brush. Trust me, you're gonna catch ticks this way. I never got bitten by a tick. Like I said earlier, a lot of that's due to permethrin, and a lot of that's due to the fact that I would just check myself every single time I went through a field. I keep saying the same thing over and over, but thank you so much to Sawyer Products for sponsoring this video. I love that company. Thank you to them as well for educating me and all of you guys about the prevention methods and the danger of Lyme disease. And so I highly recommend you guys go check out their website, sawyer.com/Lyme, for more information.
Well, that's gonna do it, folks.